This video provides an overview of the IBM watsonx stack. Even though there are many products in this stack, I'm only going to touch on the most important ones. For additional information, please refer to IBM documentation. Let's start with watsonx.data. watsonx.data can be seen as the fuel of many of the other components in this stack. watsonx.data organizes all your data repositories in a central place, combining the power of data warehouses and the flexibility of data lakes. Then we have watsonx.ai, which can be described as the brains of the stack. watsonx.ai allows you to create applications using generative AI. Then we have watsonx governance. watsonx governance enables you to evaluate, deploy, and manage the models and AI solutions you build using watsonx. Then we have watsonx assistant, which enables you to create digital assistants that use the power of AI to help customers. Then we have watsonx orchestrate, which is an automation engine that allows you to integrate different applications and create complex automations. And then we have watsonx code assistant, which is a tool for developers and allows them to create better and faster code. Now let's take a closer look at each one of these products. Let's start with watsonx.data. watsonx.data enables organizations to connect all their data sources with their own applications, providing a single point of entry for all their information needs. And the databases can be of any format. You can connect to relational databases, NoSQL databases, vector stores, or even files. How does this work? watsonx.data ingests information from these data sources and puts them in cloud buckets. Then these buckets are organized into catalogs. Catalogs allows to organize the data and create different spaces without having to duplicate the data that you have ingested. These catalogs use open formats, which means they can be accessed through different engines. So in watsonx.data, you can configure to access your data using Spark, if you want, or you can also use Presto to have SQL capabilities to interact with your data. So by doing this, watsonx.data enable people to use new technology to access all data. On top of this architecture, watsonx.data also provide services. These services help you transform and enrich your data so it can be used with generative AI. At the base of this architecture, we have metadata and governance that allows administrators to control who can access the data. Let's go back to our map of applications. Now let's take a look at watsonx.ai. watsonx.ai host a large catalog of large language models, also known as LLMs. It has Granite, which is IBM's model, and also has access to many open source LLM models, like Llama, DeepSeek R1, and many others. watsonx.ai also has a tool called Prompt Lab. Using Prompt Lab, you can interact with LLMs without having to write any line of code. The way you do it is you write a prompt, which can be a request or a question. Then you set some parameters that determine how the LLM is going to behave. This is sent to an LLM, and the LLM comes back with an output. watsonx.ai also has a new tool called Agent Lab. Agent Lab allows you to combine instructions that will specify how the agent should behave. Then you connect them to a particular framework or architecture. And then you use tools to interact with data. Using these tools and instructions, you can create agents that use RAG architectures to enrich the power of LLMs with external data and provide answers that are grounded on the information you want. Finally, there is a set of developer resources, SDKs, APIs, templates, libraries, tutorials. With these developer resources, you can quickly get up to speed and understand how you can use watsonx.ai to create generative AI applications. Now we're going to take a look at watsonx governance. watsonx governance integrates with your AI workflows and helps you save time, reduce costs, and comply with regulations. It starts by enabling you to create a catalog of your AI use cases. Some examples of AI use cases can be product routing, sentiment analysis, risk assessment, but you can determine whatever use cases you want to have. Then you can also register the AI models that you're going to use to implement the functionality associated to your use cases. Your models can be machine learning, can be generative AI models, or can be frameworks. By combining the use cases with a particular model, you create approaches to solve the problem. In watsonx governance, each approach is associated with a fact sheet, and this is a documentation that is updated automatically every time the approach evolves over time. This brings transparency and explainability to the AI process. Once you have set up your approaches in watsonx governance, you can analyze them using different dimensions. So you can first, at the beginning of your development, evaluate the quality or readability of different approaches, so you can compare them and determine which one is the better for your own use case. Once you move to production, you can monitor the quality of your approach and see if it continues to behave as you were expecting at the beginning. Sometimes the data changes over time, and monitoring your implementation will be key to make sure that your quality doesn't degrade. You can also create alerts, set some thresholds that it will trigger, and notification it will let you know that something needs your attention. Now let's take a look at watsonx Assistant. watsonx Assistant allows you to create digital assistants. These are conversational entities. They can be trained or configured to help you in a particular domain. The way you work with assistants is creating actions. An action combines a set of utterances, which are phrases or sentences that a person can say, with a particular task. So the assistant knows that when someone says something that sounds like one of those utterances, the task will be triggered, and the task will generate an answer or a response. You can have multiple actions associated to an assistant. You can also configure your assistant to route the conversation to a live agent when certain conditions are met. You can also create extensions, which allows your assistant to connect to an external application and pass control or send a request to that extension, collect information, and get back. You can also use search integrations, which allow the assistant to, in the cases where the action was not able to find the answer, to perform a search against a particular database like Milvus or Watson Discovery or Elasticsearch and retrieve a list of results that might be relevant for that particular topic. Also in Assistant, you can use watsonx.ai. watsonx.ai can be combined with the search integration to implement a RAG architecture, so your assistant not only will provide results of a search result, but rather will construct an answer grounded on the results of your search integration. Finally, in Watson Assistant, you can easily deploy your solution through different channels. You can create a web version of your assistant, but you can also integrate it with Slack, Facebook, WhatsApp, and many other third-party applications. Now, let's take a look at Watson Orchestrate. Watson Orchestrate combines the power of an automation framework with a conversational framework. In the automation framework, Watson Orchestrate has a catalog of third-party applications: Box, Gmail, Salesforce, etc. The way you interact with these apps is through skills, A skill in Watson Orchestrate is a basic unit of functionality. Each app has its own set of skills. You can invoke these skills through conversation. You can also create skill flows, which is a sequence that you configure of different steps, some of which could be skills. So you can create complex workflows that interact with multiple applications and follow different logics depending on the results of your steps. The way you interact with the skills in the skill flows is through the conversational framework. Just like in watsonx Assistant, you can also create assistants in watsonx Orchestrate. They are also made of actions, as we explained previously. One difference, though, is that in watsonx Orchestrate, the task can direct or point to a skill flow or to a skill. In watsonx Orchestrate, you can create multiple assistants, and by combining these assistants, you can create agents. The agents will be able to route the request depending on the capabilities of each assistant, creating a powerful conversational experience that can combine or assist people in different topics and domains. Finally, let's talk about watsonx Code Assistant. watsonx Code Assistant is a tool for developers. It is powered by IBM Granite foundational models that have been trained to produce code in multiple programming languages. So developers to write code use integrated development environments, also known as IDEs. IDEs are applications that help programmers to write and test their code. Watson Code Assistant provides extensions and plugins that add functionality to these IDEs. Once they are connected, you can interact with the IBM Granite models that powers Watson Code Assistant. Well, you can ask Code Assistant to write code for you. You can just describe what the code has to accomplish, and Watson Code Assistant will write it for you. You can also ask to explain a particular piece of code that you have. Let's say, for example, if you are enhancing code that you didn't write and you're not familiar with, you can just highlight it, and Watson Code Assistant will provide an explanation of what that code does. You can also use Watson Code Assistant to document your code. You can select a function, a part of your code, and say document, and it will generate useful documentation that will help maintain the code in the future. You can also ask Watson Code Assistant to write unit tests for you, simplifying the process of building code. This concludes the overview of the IBM watsonx stack. If you want to find more information about these products, please refer to the IBM documentation. Thank you.